This is a common question that I've heard in the past. Sometimes people assume that if electrical energy is controlled, it will be enough to protect the workers. We need to remember that machines are powered by a variety of energy sources, like compressed air, hydraulics, kinetic energy, or a mass in motion. Potential or stored energy, like trapped air pressure or compressed springs, can all present a risk to workers. Gravity is often overlooked. Can a part of the equipment actually fall under its own weight? If so, that also needs to be addressed. Other forms of hazardous energy can be thermal, radiation, and chemical energies. It's important to understand the energy sources that are in play so the appropriate steps can be taken to protect workers.